You had new record highs for both the NASDAQ and the NASDAQ 100 earlier today. And we do have a great guest to discuss all of this, because if she's right, the run could be about to end. Nancy Davis is the CIO of Quadratic Capital, which is a firm that specializes in quantitative analysis and strategy. She correctly predicted the short volatility blow-up of a few months back and is back with another big call. It's good to see you again. Welcome back.
Thanks for having me.
So explain to us this new call you have as we watch tech hit new highs almost every day. You think it could be about to end?
I do. If you look globally at equity markets, the U.S. markets are the only ones that are still up year to date. Every other market in the world is down, and you really saw it first hit the more fragile economies of emerging markets. That was the first thing. You saw it in EM debt. You saw it in EMFX, EM equity markets. If you look at the Chinese equity market, it's down quite substantially year to date, whereas the U.S. has been sort of this beacon of safety so far. And specifically the NASDAQ, it's been led by a handful of stocks that have been leading the rally.
It's incredible when you really look at it. We even mentioned this the other day, guys, if you remember. There's like three stocks alone have led to 70% of the gains in the S&P 500. And they're the big tech stocks that that we're talking about.
Yeah.
Whether it's Netflix or Facebook or Google,
Amazon.
And maybe getting one of Amazon. Yeah, excuse me, I may not be listing them in the correct order.
Right.
But the point is clear. A very small number of these big technology stocks have led to the overwhelming amount of growth in the market.
But Scott, you know, I've thought about that a lot, and it's not the first time it's happened. And I think that's a little misleading, because that gives you the impression that the others that, you know, almost 500 stocks of the S&P 500 haven't had gains.
No, but it gives you an idea of the outperformance, dramatically so, of big tech.
Yes, I agree.
And that's
sort
of the point.
Plenty of stocks that have done extremely well in the S&P in tech. So I really think you have to look at the bottoms-up standpoint. The question I have for you is, why now? We've had this type of narrow, you know, you can make statistics say whatever you want them to say. In this case, it's these companies that are doing it, whereas I said, I think it's broader base, right? Because we all have winners in our portfolio that are in tech in the S&P, data being one of them, Tableau. But why now? Why is now different, particularly when you've got the rest of the world that's hitting a rough spot?
Yeah, I think we can all pontificate about our views and fundamentals and all of that stuff. At Quadratic, we're really driven by market data and what the options market is telling us and what we're seeing. You know, I think the options market, you would probably agree, is like reading the tea leaves, because it's all about probability distributions.
So you're looking, you are looking at the probability of certain things happening in the market based on what you're seeing in the options market.
Exactly.
And the probability is saying to you, there is a greater probability now that the NASDAQ and the NASDAQ 100 could be about to roll over. You say it's time to take profits or short.
Yeah, so what we're seeing specifically is the stocks that have been leading the charge this year are priced to continue to outperform. And that makes sense because of so many trend following models, momentum models, factor models these days, which are quite popular. So that makes quite a lot of sense to me. But on the index level, the expectation of the continuation of the rally is much lower. It's almost half of what the individual stock prices are.
And Nancy, what are you specifically looking at? Is it put to call ratios? Is it implied volatility? What are those metrics?
Yeah, so it's all implied volatility, and specifically we're looking at skew. So okay. What skew is it's a probability distribution of expected returns. So if you take an at-the-money option, which would be a 50 delta, and you look at the upside strike, which maybe is a 35 delta call, and you look at the difference in the probabilities of what the market is expecting. At the same time, you can look at the downside probabilities of what the market is pricing in for a potential sell-off.
How often has your model had the same output? And what has the response been in the, or what has the outcome been in the market? In other words, what's the track record of the model?
Yeah, I mean, you take the model.
How long has it been around?
Oh, so our model, it's called QSAM, the Quadratic Structural Alpha Monitor. Been using it for almost 19 years, so it's a long model. But you also have to take into account the other macro variables that are going on in today's environment. We have negative QE coming from the Fed. We have central banks easing, tightening liquidity and all the quantitative easing is stopping. The Fed has been on a hiking path. You also have protectionism going on. And it's kind of bizarre that you would look at the Chinese equity markets, which are also very tech-driven, that have been, you know, selling off dramatically this year, whereas the NASDAQ is hitting all-time new highs. That's a real dichotomy. So I think what our models are really saying is either EM has to close the gap and rally back up, or the U.S. is overpriced and needs to sell off to meet the rest of the world. So that's sort of the premise of what we're seeing.
Nancy, thanks for being here. Appreciate you bearing with us as well. There's so much breaking news happening all around the world today. Nancy Davis with Quadratic. We'll have you back soon.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.